the 800 meters, one of the most brutal, painful, and dramatic events in track and field. At just two laps around the track, world-class athletes have just over 100 seconds to strategize and execute their race plan. Although this race is relatively short, any athlete who has ever run an all-out 800 meters will tell you, it hurts, and it hurts a lot. In order to become an elite runner in this event, you'll need incredible natural speed, superior endurance, and a powerful finishing kick. Although the best athletes in the world make running this distance look easy, performing at the highest levels requires not just natural talent, but a very special kind of athletic discipline. The current world record is held by the great David Rudisha from Kenya, who ran a time of 1 minute 40.91 seconds. During the London Olympic final in 2012, Rudisha ran what is widely considered the single greatest 800-meter race of all time. This performance was the only occasion where an athlete broke the 1 minute and 41 second barrier. Rudisha is clearly one of those special athletes you see only once in every generation, and very few runners have ever managed to run anywhere near his times. Although African-born runners have held the 800-meter world record since 1997, many countries have played a very important role in breaking through new barriers for the 800-meter record. The first official world record for the 800 meters was set by Ted Meredith on July 8, 1912. Racing in Stockholm, Sweden, he ran a very impressive time of 1 minute 51.90 seconds. At the young age of 21, he set the world record during the Olympic finals, and just a few days after this victory, he won yet another gold medal in the 4x400-meter relay. Basically, Meredith was an absolute beast, and in addition to his fantastic 800 time, he also broke the 440-yard world record in 1916 by running a time of 47.4 seconds. At 5'9" and 157 pounds, Meredith was a stocky but powerful runner with tons of natural speed. This world record lasted for an impressive 14 years, making it one of the longest-lasting 800-meter records in history. For the following 20 years after Meredith, athletes from around the world attempted to break the elusive 1 minute and 50 second barrier. In order to break this time, an athlete would need to achieve an average 400-meter pace of under 55 seconds, or an average 200-meter pace of 27.5. By today's standards, a sub 1 minute and 50 second 800 is quite common. However, in 1932, no athlete had ever accomplished this time. At the 1932 Olympic 800-meter finals, Tommy Hampson from Great Britain would at long last run a 1:49. With a strong finishing kick down the home stretch, Hampson ran a time of 1 minute 49.8 seconds. This time not only broke the world record, but it helped him win the Olympic gold medal in the 800. For the next 7 years, the world record was improved on four different occasions. However, the overall improvement was only 1.4 seconds. Indeed, it seemed as though running a 1:47 could potentially be the human limit. However, on July 15, 1939, Rudolf Harbig from Germany ran a time so fast that it remained unbroken for 16 years. With his new world record time of 1 minute 46.6 seconds, Harbig smashed the previous time by almost 2 seconds. Sadly, no footage exists of this race, but according to legend, this race ended with one of the most powerful sprint finishes in 800-meter history, and this stunning performance stood unchallenged for well over a decade. Throughout the 1940s, no athlete even came close to this time, and as the 1950s began, Harbig's mark still stood very strong. However, on August 3, 1955, Belgian runner Roger Mowens did the unthinkable by running a new 800-meter world record of 1 minute 45.7 seconds. This performance was the first time any athlete had run under 1:46, and it did seem as though he would soon be under 1:45. After his world record achievement, he looked towards the 1960 Olympics. For this race, he was the clear favorite. However, an unknown runner from New Zealand caught the entire world off guard. Over the final 50 meters of the Olympic final in 1960, Peter Snell overtook the great Belgian runner, and this new Olympic victory marked the changing of the guard for 800-meter greatness. Only 2 years after Peter Snell's 1960 Olympic gold, he finally overtook the previous world record on February 2nd, 1962. With a fantastic time of 1 minute 44.3 seconds, Snell smashed the previous mark by over a second. This record was extremely significant for a few reasons. First, Snell became the first athlete to ever run the 800 under 1 minute and 45 seconds. Second, he accomplished this feat on a grass track, which is simply amazing. And lastly, and perhaps most impressively, Snell's time of 1:44.3 still remains as New Zealand's 800-meter national record, making it the oldest recognized national record by the IAAF. This means that for 58 years, Snell has held the 800-meter record for New Zealand, and while his world record for the 800 was stunning, he also broke world records for the 1,000 meters and for the 1-mile distance. For 6 years, Snell remained the untouchable world record holder. However, like all world records, someone faster eventually came along. On October 15, 1968, Ralph Dubell from Australia ran one of the greatest 800-meter races in history. Finishing with an amazing time that equaled Snell at 1:44.3, Dubell outlasted his Kenyan rival Wilson Kiprigut at the 1968 Olympic Finals in Mexico City. Over the final 100 meters, Dubell unleashed a brutal finishing kick, and although his finishing time was the exact same as Peter Snell's, it was soon confirmed that he was also the new 800-meter world record holder. For 4 years, Dubell's time, along with Snell's, was absolutely untouchable. But on July 1st, 1972, a tall, lean, and extremely fast runner from the United States would completely rewrite the history books once again. Competing at the United States Olympic Trials, Dave Waddell again matched the previous 800-meter mark by running a time of 1 minute 44.3 seconds. This performance was quite unique, as it was the first time that an athlete had ever negative split an 800-meter world record. While this record was certainly incredible, his greatest achievement came just 2 months later at the Olympic Games, where he ran one of the most dramatic but perfectly timed 800-meter races in Olympic history. For the first lap, Waddell was in last place by a huge margin, but as the final lap unfolded, he passed runner after runner, and down the final home stretch, he maintained his pace and somehow won the Olympic gold medal. This is easily one of the greatest races ever run, and Waddell's patience, along with his great endurance, created this unforgettable Olympic victory. Just 1 year after Dave Waddell broke the 800-meter record, Marcello Fiasconaro from Italy became the first runner to ever run under 1 minute and 44 seconds. On June 27, 1973, in a small meet in Milan, Fiasconaro powered away from a world-class field to easily win with a stunning time of 1 minute 43.7 seconds. This time still stands as Italy's national record, and although he looked to be in great form during this race, Fiasconaro would sadly never run faster. Now, with a 1 minute and 44 second barrier defeated, athletes were curious as to how low the record could go. Perhaps reaching 1:42 would be the ultimate time, or perhaps one day a 1:39 would be possible. The reality of achieving these times was completely unknown, and as the years progressed, four individual athletes would shatter all racing expectations. On July 25, 1976, one of the most influential and talented runners in track and field history would cement himself as one of the greats in the 800 meters. Just like many athletes before, Alberto Juantorena broke the world record in the 800 meters at the Olympic Finals in 1976. This performance was absolutely tremendous, as his raw speed and pure power were simply too much for any of the competition. He was so strong and so fast that he also won the 400-meter Olympic gold in the same Olympics. This sensational Olympic double is the only time in history where an athlete won both the 400 and the 800 meters in the same Olympics. Following these amazing performances, Juantorena somehow outdid himself again. On August 21st, 1977, the tall and powerful Cuban ran a time of 1 minute 43.44 seconds, breaking his own world record by 1/10 of a second. Juantorena is clearly one of those special athletes you only see once in every generation, and with such unbelievable personal bests in both the 400 and the 800, he will always be remembered as one of the most talented and versatile runners of all time. And wow, does he have one of the largest strides I have ever seen. For 2 years, Juan Torena's record went unchallenged. However, on July 5th, 1979, Sebastian Coe from Great Britain completely outperformed everyone's expectations. With one of the largest margins of victory in any 800-meter race, Coe broke the previous record by a full second. With a finishing time of 1 minute 42.4 seconds, the entire world was in shock after Coe ran this time. For the previous 17 years, the world record had only been improved by 0.9 seconds, and with this one extraordinary performance, Coe slashed a whole second off the record. But he wasn't done. Just 2 years later in Florence, Italy, Coe lowered his own world record with an unreal time of 1 minute 41.73 seconds. This race was yet another moment of complete dominance, and his margin of victory? Well, it was about 30 meters. Absolutely amazing. Over the course of just 2 years, Coe took the world record from 143.4 down to 141.7. Coe's performances were absolutely mind-blowing, and for the next 16 years, athletes tried to break Coe's record, only to find that running under 142 was almost impossible. As it always happens, eventually someone new came along, and this athlete was Wilson Kipketer from Denmark. Although he represented Denmark, Kipketer is Kenyan-born, and he ran an amazing time to break Coe's record. Although he ran a 141.73, Kipketer would continue to improve for the next month and a half. On August 13, 1997, about 1 month after he already tied the world record, Kipketer struck again with a new world record of 141.24, officially beating the previous time by half a second. Although he did smash the record in this race, Kipketer's pacing was wild. Through the first 400 meters, he split a time of 48.3 seconds, which to this day remains as the fastest opening lap in 800-meter world record history. Although he was very quick through the opening 400 meters, he slowed dramatically over the final lap, only achieving a time of 52.9 seconds. Given this extremely off-balance racing strategy, he knew he had more in the tank, and just 11 days later on August 24th, he would again lower his own world record to a sensational time of 1 minute 41.11 seconds. This record stood for 13 years, and during that time, no athlete even ran within 1 second of this amazing performance. But then, the world saw an 800-meter athlete like no other runner in history. Throughout his 2010 season, David Rudisha quickly became the fastest 800-meter runner in the world, and he was improving at lightning speed. Although he was only 21 years of age, the young Kenyan prodigy was ready to make history. On August 22nd of 2010, Rudisha ran a time of 1 minute 41.09 seconds, finally defeating Wilson Kipketer's timeless record. However, Rudisha was just getting started. Just 7 days later, Rudisha again broke the world record with an amazing time of 1 minute 41.01 seconds, just barely missing the almost impossible 1 minute and 40 second 800. Watching Rudisha run was incredible. His stride was so effortless, his execution so perfect, and his dominance, well, he was in a league of his own. After another dominant year in 2011 and a solid early 2012, Rudisha went into the 2012 Olympics with one goal, to smash the world record by any means possible. And although he had already made this incredible prediction, nobody was ready for what Rudisha was about to do in the 800-meter final. Leading from the gun, Rudisha's pace was simply unrelenting. Through the first 200 meters, he split 23.5 seconds, and through the first lap, Rudisha ran a time of 49.28 seconds. This pace was already extremely quick. However, with 300 meters remaining, Rudisha continued striding forward, and the field wilted behind him. Through 600 meters, Rudisha split an almost inhuman time of 1 minute 14.30 seconds. Over the final 200 meters, Rudisha remained as strong as ever, and in absolutely dominant fashion, he broke his own world record again, except this time, he finally broke the 1 minute and 41 second barrier with an incredible time of 1 minute 40.91 seconds. This Olympic gold medal was more than just a supreme victory. It was a true display that Rudisha was in fact the greatest 800 meter runner in the world. He was absolutely untouchable, and while most world records for the 800 are achieved by using a pacer through the first lap, Rudisha proved that he didn't need a pacer. He just needed the right opportunity to display his unmatched talents. Thanks for watching, everyone, and we'll see you all again very soon.